Very good morning to all of you. This is the 21st lecture for the subject Power System and Tools. In the previous lecture, day 20, we had discussed regarding the what do you really mean by lightning and what are the mechanism of lightning discharge. So continuing the previous lecture, in this today's topic, we are going to discuss the types of lightning strokes. So there are mainly two types of lightning strokes. There are two ways in which lightning may strike the power system. Power system comprises of overhead lines, towers, substations, and many more, etc. Namely, there may be transformers, alternators. So there are many ways in which lightning may strike the power system, but the two ways will be the direct stroke or indirect stroke. Lightning may strike the power system in the shape of direct stroke or in the shape of indirect stroke. In order to explain the direct stroke, I have taken an example of stroke A, stroke B, nomenclatures as 1 and 2. In the below figures, we are going to discuss regarding what do you really mean by stroke A and stroke B. So as we see the diagram, as we see in this diagram, stroke A, when a cloud of positively charged particles, ये जैसे ही हमारा किसी भी टॉल ऑब्जेक्ट, एक पॉजिटिवली चार्ज क्लाउड है, जैसे भी कोई भी टॉल ऑब्जेक्ट, इट में भी टॉवर, इट में भी बिल्डिंग, जब भी किसी से पास करेगा तो इट विल इंड्यूस नेगेटिव चार्ज ऑन द ट्रांसमिशन लाइन ड्यू टू द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन इफेक्ट. ठीक है, इट विल इंड्यूस द नेगेटिवली चार्ज पार्टिकल्स, negatively charged electrons on the transmission line. So when the potential difference between this cloud and this line becomes greater than the strength of the air, insulating strength of the air, or gradient between the cloud and the transmission line is greater than the insulating strength of the air, a discharge will occur over the transmission line. So this discharge current flows through the insulators by the support to the ground. This support is of steel tower. So this form of lightning occurs rarely in power system. Direct strokes occur rarely in power system. Indirect strokes occur usually. So this is all about the stroke A. Take when a cloud passes a tall object, it will induce an opposite polarity charge on the transmission line. So the excessive current due to the charge induced will flow over the insulator by the tower to the ground. So this is the first effect. Stroke B, in the stroke B, in stroke B, in spite of one cloud, if there are three clouds named P, Q, and R, if the electric discharge or lightning occurs between the cloud P and Q, or you can say that there are three clouds P, Q, and R. R cloud is bounded by the cloud Q. If there is another cloud P, if the discharge lightning occurs between, if the cloud P comes closer to cloud Q, the lightning discharge occurs between P and Q. These both clouds will immediately neutralize each other. ठीक है, then the cloud R remains left behind. अगर ये पीछे रह जाता है cloud R, अब ये किसी से भी bound नहीं है. This is a free cloud, so it will discharges rapidly to the ground, irrespective of the whether the tall object available or not, it will rapidly discharge to the ground. Okay, so there may be building, tower, or ground, it will rapidly charge. there is no condition if a tower or building or anything is present or not, it will rapidly discharge. So this is a stroke B, where if two clouds are bounce each other, there is a third cloud which when came close to this cloud, neutralizes both the effects. This cloud remains free, so it will discharge rapidly to ground irrespective of the power object available or not available. So these both cases explains the lightning strokes, direct lightning strokes. So in indirect strokes, what happens when the cloud overhead the transmission line passes over the transmission line, the area below the ground due to the electromagnetic induction, electrostatically induced charges get concentrated beneath the area of the cloud. जितना क्लाउड का बड़ा एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन होगा उतना ही हमारा इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिकली इंडक्शन के कारण उतना ही चार्ज हमारा स्टोर रहेगा. तो बाकी जो एरिया रहेगा पावर कंडक्टर का उसमें पॉजिटिव चार्ज इंड्यूस होगा. ठीक है, जैसे ही ये क्लाउड डिस्चार्ज हो करेगा, जो क्लाउड मूव करेगा, तो ये जो चार्ज है ये डिसिपेट करेगा फॉरवर्ड एंड बैकवर्ड पोजिशन इन द शेप ऑफ ट्रेवलिंग वेव्स. सो बेसिकली दिस इज द केस for the introduction of surges in a transmission line. Surges is a increase in the value of the voltage level for a very short duration of time. This is the main cause for the surges in the transmission line. Okay. So majority of the surges in a transmission line are caused by indirect strokes. So what is there? There is a cloud. Beneath the cloud, there is charge concentrated. When the cloud move away or discharges, the charge rapidly moves forward, backward, representing the traveling nature of the charge. So due to these, the surges develop in the power system. So this is all about the strokes. Thank you, guys.